हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट लर्निंग द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक द क्लॉजेस। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट टू टाइप्स ऑफ द क्लॉजेस, द प्रिंसिपल क्लॉज एंड द कोऑर्डिनेट क्लॉज। वी लर्नड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल क्लॉज एंड द कोऑर्डिनेट क्लॉज रेस्पेक्टिवली। हैविंग लर्नड okay about this first two types of the clauses comprising the principal clause and the coordinate clause, now it is the turn to learn about the subordinate clause. So now I would like to write here the name of the third type of clause number 3. This is clause number 3, clause, clause number 3. The name of the clause is the subordinate clause. The subordinate clause. The second name of this clause is dependent clause. The dependent clause, the dependent clause. Okay, so what is the definition of this clause? I would like to write here. Okay, the name of the third clause is the subordinate clause, subordinate, and the or the dependent clause. Okay, so now I would like to write here the definition. Let's start learning the definition first. If somebody asks you about the definition of this third type of the clauses, the subordinate clause, so how would you like to define it? So you first learn it very nicely. Definition, definition. So what is the definition here? Okay, what is the definition here? I tell you. The subordinate clause, this subordinate clause is one that contains its own subject verb and predicate but it has to depend on any other sentence to make its complete sense. Okay, it always starts with a subordinating conjunction like with a subordinating conjunction like when while as soon as etc. So beta, the definition is very easy. If you want to learn it, you can easily learn it beta. The subordinate clause is one. सबोर्डिनेट क्लोज उसको कहते हैं, वह होता है दैट कंटेन्स इट्स ऑन सब्जेक्ट, जिसका अपना सब्जेक्ट होता है, वर्ब होती है और उसका प्रेडिकेट भी होता है. बट इट ऑलवेज हैज टू डिपेंड ऑन एनी अदर सेंटेंस. मैंने ऑलवेज नहीं लिखा, कोई बात नहीं, बट इट हैज टू डिपेंड ऑन एनी अदर सेंटेंस टू मेक इट्स कंप्लीट सेंस. ओके, इट ऑलवेज स्टार्ट विद ए सबोर्डिनेटिव कंजक्शन लाइक सो एंड सो. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन. Okay, and you can underline it also if you think so. Otherwise, there is no need. Okay, beta. If you want to underline it, you can underline it. Okay. Here I give an example also. What is the example here? Okay. My friend was swimming in a pool when I saw him. So the first sentence in this statement, here are two statements, here are two sentences in this statement. So the first statement is the part of the principal clause and it is known as the principal clause. This is called PC, principal clause. And this one, when I saw him, this the statement is called the dependent clause beta, DC. Okay, because this the statement starts with the conjunction when, as you can see here. What is this? When. So in the beginning of this, the next statement, you find here the use of the conjunction when, which is called a subordinating conjunction. When को क्या कहते हैं? Subordinating conjunction कहते हैं, subordinating conjunction कहते हैं, ठीक है? तो subordinating conjunction जो कोई भी वाक्य start होता है, तो बेटा उसको हम किस प्रकार का clause कहेंगे? Subordinate clause कहेंगे. और उस बगैर किसी clause के कोई sentence, बगैर किसी conjunction के कोई sentence लिखा जाता है, उसको क्या बोलते हैं? Principal clause कहते हैं. So I think up to here everything is clear. Okay. Now let's start. Okay. To the next point. Dear students, now let's start proceeding to the next point. So what could it be? So now I would like to put the details of the subordinate clause. DE TAI, little study. Of subordinate clause. CLAUSE, detailed study of subordinate clauses. Okay, I would like to write the name of here the subordinate clause, subordinate clause, CLAUSES, clauses. Because there are three parts of this clause, that's why we have written the name here in plural for clauses. Otherwise, we would have written here clause. So now I write here the names of the subordinate clauses here. There are three kinds of subordinate clauses. First is noun clause. N-O-U-N, noun clause. C-L-A-U-S-E. The second one is adjective clause, CLAUSE, and the third is here adverb clause, CLAUSE. Okay, beta. So now you will have to learn these three kinds of adverbial clauses, known as the noun clause, the adjective clause, and the adverb clause. So I would like to write here the definition of the noun clause. What is a noun clause? Okay? And how does it function? So first of all, we should learn the noun clause. Okay? Now here are, there is no other further classification of the noun clause and adjective clause, but here are parts of adverb clause. I write here 8 kinds of adverb clauses. 1. Adverbial clauses of time. Adverbial clauses of adverbial clauses of place. Adverbial clauses of region. Adverbial clauses of purpose. Adverbial clauses of relation. Adverbial clauses of manner. Okay, beta, adverbial clauses of manner. Now the next one is here. Adverbial clauses of condition. Next one is here. Adverbial clauses of comparison. And the next is here, adverbial clauses of concession. Adverbial clauses of concession. I have written here adverbial clauses of condition. Adverbial clauses of comparison. Adverbial clauses of concession. So how many kinds are of their adverbial clauses? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here are 8 to 9 kinds of, 9 kinds of adverbial clauses. And if there is any more, so we can also write it here. But I think here are only 8 to 9 kinds of adverbial clauses. So here are only one more which can be written by us here, the students. But generally we read adverbial clauses of result, R-E-S-U-L-T. So here are these 9 to 10 kinds of adverbial clauses. So these are the 10 kinds of adverbial clauses will be learnt by later. First of all, we would like to learn the first type of the adverbial clauses. What is the name of the first type of adverbial clauses? Noun clause. Noun clause. So I would like to start learning, we would like to start noun clause here. So I draw a line here. So noun clause. What is a noun clause? Definition. Definition, bete. A noun clause. C-L-A-U-S-E clause. Is a group of words which contains its subject and predicate and does the work as a noun. And does the work as a noun. Is known as a noun clause. So here are different kinds of examples which I can give you here. First of all, I give an example here. Do you know? Do you know? Do you know who broke the glass? Who broke the glass? Okay. Do you know who broke the glass? So here in the statement, as you can see here, I have written here this is the part. So this is the part of the noun clause. Who broke the glass? Because here the name of the person is not mentioned here, but we want to know how we want to know it. Who broke the glass? Suppose we have written here the name of the person, so then it will be called as an adjective clause. Dekho beta. Suppose I write here the name of any person before this word who. So then in that case it would be called as an as a sentence of the adjective clause. But here there is no word, particular words, that's why it is known as a noun clause. A noun clause is a group of words. The definition is very easy. A noun clause is a group of words, okay, which contains its subject and predicate, as you can see here, and does the work as a noun is called the noun clause. Okay, I have written the definition. So now I would like to write here some rules here, basic rules, important rules. Point number two, this is the point number first definition. Basic rules. What are the basic rules? I write here. A noun clause works. Okay. Number one, noun clause works as an object to a verb or as an object to a, first of all I write here, the first rule. It works as an object to a verb. Okay? As an object to a verb, bete. Example is here. I know what you say. What you say. But here this the part is known as the noun clause. Because here the verb is know and the remaining part of the statement is connected to this verb. Okay, that's why it is known as a part of the noun clause and it functions as per the nature of, as per the verb as included in the statement. Okay. The next one is here, second rule. Rule number two. As an object to a preposition. As an object to a preposition. Noun clause works as an object to a preposition. In what sense? I would like to tell you here. बेटा ये सब इसके rules हैं, आपने पढ़े भी होंगे पहले class 10th में, यदि नहीं पढ़े तभी ध्यान से पढ़ लेना. ये इसके basic rules हैं noun clause के. So I write here the second rule, an example here. Okay. Kindly listen to. Kindly listen to what the teacher says to you. So here in this statement you can see here, this is the preposition to, and after this preposition the part which is connected here after this preposition is known as the is known as an objective part of this preposition. Okay, so kindly listen to. So whenever you find any preposition, and after preposition if you use the words like who, what, where, which, when, okay, so we generally use who, whom, whose, what, which, that, how, etc. Okay, so whenever you find the presence of any such word like what, who, whom, whose, which, that, how, why, etc. So after preposition, so this the rule number second is justified there. Okay, first of all, a noun clause works as an object to a verb. As you can hear, after this verb we write whatsoever we write here, it works as an object to the verb, and whatsoever we write here after this preposition is works as an object to a preposition. Okay, so the remaining rules will be discussed based in the next lecture. Okay, kindly note them down in your pen notebook. Thank you.